Good morning, students. So today we'll start with a fresh unit as we have already completed last unit with all the topics. So now I'll start with the unit 3, where I have to start with the parallel or series interfacing. So first we'll start with the parallel interfacing. In the parallel interfacing, we need to see GPIB, IEEE 488 bus, which is also your general purpose interface bus. This is also known as GPIB, which is general purpose interface bus. Now, the application of this IEEE 488 is in for automation, for testing and measurement. For that purpose, we need a computer with suitable configuration, measuring instruments which need to be monitored through the computer, and a bus network. This is your bus network through where the communication can be done. And the fourth part is your testing, software testing or software program through where the testing of the equipment can be done. Okay, so now all that can be connected in like this as a diagram. So here the PC bus is there, PC or the controller is there, which is controlling all the instruments which are connected through the communication cable. Now through this communication bus. Now this bus network is known as IEEE 488 or general purpose interface bus. So, what is the advantage of using IEEE 488 network? The advantage is it makes the process very convenient, as lot of hardware interfacing is reduced, and it can bring up to the single interface network through where the more and more hardware and their wiring can be reduced. So this is the advantage, and it is easy to reconfigure and very fast, and maximum data transfer rate is 1 megabyte per second. So the instruments can be connected here, and the maximum limit of the instrument is 15 instruments. Not more than 15 instruments can be connected for a particular application. So this is used for in automation for testing and measurement. So how it can be used? The instruments which are connected over the communication bus, that your all the instruments have their particular listening address and talking address. So all the instruments which are connected here, they have their particular listening address and communication address. So this addressing is done through address mode. Now each instrument connected to interface has unique system address, which is being done through the addressing mode. A particular instrument have different talking address and listening address. Why this talking and listening address? That I'll explain you with the help of an example. Now in automation, some instrument work as a listener, some as a talker, and one as a talker and listener both. So as you know, one is your controller, which is controlling all the process, all the instruments which are connected there and acquiring the data. And after acquiring the data, then the analysis can be done in the through the help of the controller. So controller itself act as a talker and listener, whereas the devices which are connected over the network, so some of the devices are only listeners and some are talkers also. And otherwise, when the controller will send the command, so more than 14, maximum 14 devices can be act as the listener. Maximum 14. Out of 15 instruments, maximum 14 instruments can be act as the listener here. Now, communication between the devices is very fast and reliable. So that's why GPIB is used wherever only 15 instruments or 10 instruments need to be connected. So it is quite reliable for any automation application. So I would like to explain this with the help of an example so that you can able to understand that what is the how this GPIB behaves as the through the GPIB, how the interfacing can be done with the help of the talker and listener and the controller. So this is an example. This is an example of testing an audio amplifier. Testing an audio amplifier. Now, testing an audio amplifier. So here your computer acts as the controller. It is acting as the controller. Your computer is acting as the controller because it is controlling all the process, whole the process. So now I have to test here audio amplifier. So the devices connected across it is waveform analyzer, function generator, DC supply, amplifier. So all these devices are connected. Now how the operation is being done? So firstly, computer initialize the process and set the command to DC supply. Let's say first number is DC supply. So computer is initiating the process and set the command, send the command to the DC supply system to start the put the voltage into a desirable range and give the supply to the amplifier. Okay, so computer will start the process, it initiates the process and send the command to the DC supply. Now the DC supply source at that time is at the listener mode because talker is the one which sends the data on the bus. Talker is the one which sends the data on the bus. Listener is the one. Listener, talker is the one which sends the data on the bus from the desired address and communicate with the controller. Now, listener is the one which receives the data. What is the difference between talker and listener? Talker is the one which sends the data and listener is the one which receives the data from the bus or from the control through the controller on the bus network or from the other devices also. Okay, now talker and listener is what? Talker and listener both a device which can act as a talker as well as a listener and which manages all the flow of information is done through the controller or through the master. It can be also used as the master slave process because the whole information data flow management can be done or can be controlled with the help of the computer through the software program. So now they have for the talker and listener, all the devices have their system address as their talking as address as well as their listening address. So one, they will switch from the talker to the listener or from the listener to the talker, all these devices, any of these devices, then their listening address will deactivate and then their talker address will be activated. So the device which can be act as a talker and listener both at the time is the computer or a controller which manages the flow of information. Now see how does this process will be going on. Now computer sends the command to the DC supply to start the process, to measure, start the process and to select at the desired voltage range and input the power supply and give the power supply to the amplifier. So now DC supply act as a listener. So here the DC supply is acting as the listener. So DC supply is acting as the listener and then DC supply will start the process and give the power input to the amplifier. Okay. Now computer will deactivate this DC supply. Now it will activate the listening address of the function generator and start giving the command to the function generator to produce the audio signal. Produce the audio signal for the amplifier. Now, function generator, which is also a listener, function generator is also a listener. I am already given the example here that DC supply and function generator is acting as the listener, because right now they are the computer or controller is acting as a talker, and it is talking to the function generator and sending the command that what instruction to be performed by the function generator or what instruction to be performed by the DC supply. Now once the function generator listen the command or the instruction of the computer, then computer will deactivate it and the function generator will perform its function. After that, once the audio signal is given to the amplifier, now amplifier will perform the function and it produces the output voltage. Now it produces the output signal. Now once the output signal is produced, now what is the function of waveform analyzer? Waveform analyzer will analyze the voltage signal through the through its mechanism, and there is a screen or a CRO through where the signal is visible, or you can analyze the signal, or DSO, and through the DSO it can be further sent to the computer or can be further given or sent to the computer. Now waveform analyzer, because this data waveform analyzer is the third one. Now after the data has come to the waveform analyzer, then waveform analyzer can act as the talker, and it can send the data, because through the waveform analyzer the data can be sent to the computer. Now computer, who was earlier talker and talking to the function generator and DC supply generator and then amplifier, but now the computer deactivates its talking address and becomes listener. Now the talking command has been sent to the waveform analyzer. Now waveform analyzer activates at its talking address, and now it will ask computer whether to send the data or not. Then once it is communicated to it, the data is ready now whether to send to you or not. In that case, computer will be acting as the listener and waveform analyzer acting as the talker. After that, computer deactivates its talking address command, and once the data has been sent, now the computer again becomes the talker, and waveform analyzer deactivates from its talker address, and now the computer is again your talker and listener both. So in this way the whole process works. So here the information flows through the talker, listener and controller. So controller is the overall which manages the flow of the information, and the devices act as the talker or a listener, depends on where, if the data is sent by the device on the bus, then it becomes the talker. If the data is received by the device on through the bus network from the controller, then it acts as the listener. So they have their talking address and listening address, and there are certain programming commands by using those commands and particular addresses, then these devices can communicate on the network. So in this way the IEEE 488 bus system works, and the advantages of this network I have already discussed. It is very easy to set up and reconfigure it, and the data transfer rate is in 1 megabyte per second, and maximum 15 instruments can be connected on the bus interface system, and it can work as the in automation it can work as the talker, some instrument work as talker listener and talker and listener both. So they have their different talking and listening address, and addressing is done through the address mode, and the hardware interface it reduces the hardware as all the devices can be connected on a single interface system. So that's why we can use the IEEE 488 bus, which is general purpose interface bus. So with more examples and its pin diagram, I'll start with the next class. So this is all for today's class. I hope at least you got the idea that how this parallel interfacing can be done with the help of the talker, listener, and the talker and listener as a controller both. So with this concept, this whole system works. So there are short programs also that we'll discuss later on. Okay, thank you.